Hello friends, so today's video is a very short video. In fact, it's actually a correction video from the previous lecture in which we were deriving the equation for the reverse recovery charge, reverse recovery time and the reverse recovery current. So in this particular equation, you can see it's not a major correction actually. So you can see that IRR square divided by DI by DT the whole square is equal to 2QRR divided by DI by DT. So we can cancel this and we can cancel this. So finally you will get IRR square, I forgot to put this. So IRR square is equal to 2QRR into DI divided by DT. So I just forgot to put the square root in the final equation. So the final equation IRR will be equal to root of 2QRR into DI divided by DT. So very sorry for this. But anyway, it was not a major mistake. I am sure that most of you might have found out that also. Another thing was that in the numerical which we were discussing, I forgot to do the second part of the numerical. Okay, so we'll do that also now. So we found out that the reverse recovery charge or the storage charge QRR was equal to 135 microcoulomb. Okay, so the second part of the question was to find out the reverse recovery current. Okay, so the reverse recovery current, you just derived the equation that is equal to root of QRR into DI divided by DT. So you have already found out what is the value of the reverse recovery charge, that is QRR in this equation, sorry, in this numerical will be equal to 135 microcoulomb. Okay, and DI divided by DT is already given in the numerical, that is equal to 30 ampere per microsecond. 30 ampere per microsecond. So we'll put that here. So it will be root of 2 into QRR is how much? 135 microcoulomb multiplied by 30 ampere divided by microsecond, ampere per microsecond. So in SI units, IRR, you want to find it in amperes. So we will do a conversion. We'll convert all the micro values into its SI units. Okay. So first micro coulombs, we'll convert it into coulombs. So 2 into 135 into 10 power minus 6 coulombs. Okay. So you can convert micro coulombs into coulombs by multiplying by 10 power minus 6. Multiplied by 30 amperes, so this is okay, divided by, this is microseconds, this is microseconds, so divided by 10 power minus 6, okay, seconds, okay, so this will become 10 power minus 6 seconds. So you can easily see that this will get cancelled and this will get cancelled, so you will get root of 2 into 135 into 30. So if you find out this equation, you will find that IRR is equal to 90 amperes. So you can see that the reverse recovery current in this numerical, you can find that that is 90 ampere. It is quite a high value. Okay. So in the next video, as I already told, we will be seeing what is the use of this reverse recovery time, reverse recovery current in actually the classification of diodes. So I hope I can see you in the next video. So till I see you in the next video, it's me Varun signing off and have a great day. Thank you. Now that the video is over, please stay with me for 30 more seconds. Now the vision of this channel is to create a repository of good quality videos with crystal clear explanation regarding various topics related to electrical engineering. Now, if you want to help me spread the word, please share this video with anyone interested in these topics. The second thing is that for me, education is a two-way process. Therefore, if you have any doubts or suggestions regarding any of the videos or regarding the channel, please put them in the comments below. We can have a healthy discussion and that way we can build a strong community of electrical engineers. So that's it for today's video. So till I see you in the next time, it's me Varun signing off and have a great day. Thank you.